1. Mathematics is the language of nature. 2. Everything around us can be represented and understood through numbers. 3. If you graph the numbers of any system, patterns emerge.
When people talk science fiction, they always say 2001, Space Odyssey. It's a brilliant film.
It's more of a meditation than it is a narrative.
All right, now. I'll go in through the emergency airlock.
It is a science fiction film. Fits all the marks of spaceship. It's one of those misdirection films where it allows the filmmaker to explore issues and talk about humanity on a level that
deals with very complex issues and doesn't resolve them. It's left open-ended.
If we go out there, are we going to find God? Or is it somehow what's out there disprove the existence of God? That's what the film is completely about, is about the existence of God.
Ultimate questions, they are beyond maybe even the scope of human understanding.
What is it?
Part of the test?
No, just warming you up, that's all.
If you're doing a science fiction piece, you have complete freedom to have people be as human as possible.
More human than human is our motto.
Shall we continue?
How can it not know what it is?
Commerce.
What does it mean to have a, quote, soul? Is there a God?
Quite honestly, I wouldn't worry myself about that.
But it gives a great platform to look at some of the really, really big issues in life.
What does the water do?
It must be part of the power system. The ocean tides are turned into energy somehow.
Bigger issues than mankind.
We have been looking for that key ever since.
It allows the audience to think they're going to watch a type of film, and then it sucker punches them.
Morbius.
What?
Something is approaching from the southwest. It is now quite close.
And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
This sort of co-evolution of the cinema and the society.
It's a door!
A door at the front of a cliff. You're driving yourself over the edge.
Demonstrate it. I want to see it work.
The filmic quality takes over and supersedes sort of the conventions of the genre.
There's a damn company. What about our lives, you son of a bitch?
In coming here, you've exposed yourself to toxic gas.
Not so much co-evolve society, although it leads to that, but definitely evolve the art form.
How do we kill it, Ash? There's gotta be a way of killing it. How do we do it?
You can't.
Go outside and make me a liar.
You're in a desert, walking along in the sand when all of a sudden...
Is this the test now?
Yes. You're in a desert, walking along in the sand when all of a sudden you look
down...
What?
A desert.
Right now, it's a critical moment in time.
Really?
Yeah.
I remember when I read Ray Bradbury's The Marcia Chronicles for the first time. When I was reading them, I realized what made these stories great wasn't because it was about the moon and exploring space and all that kind of stuff.
How come I'm from outer space, Nancy?
Why?
What are you talking about, a space flower?
Well, why not a space flower? Why do we always expect metal ships?
Human fears and dreams and memories and, you know, how our prejudices and but he could use the science fiction genre, if you will, to deceive people into think they're over. It's about spaceships and, you know, space travel, but when in fact he was talking at the core heart of what it meant to be a human being.
The best ones do that.
Amazing! Yo, Hebrew's all math. It's all numbers.
According to the inventory, we're low on everything.
This is the answer. If we could somehow harness this light.
It's always, of course, about technology and quite often about the failure of technology.
Your minds and memories will be totally absorbed. Everything remains intact.
To be the sort of savior of humanity.
Quite frankly, we have had some very reliable intelligence reports that quite a serious epidemic has broken out at Clarius. Something apparently of an unknown origin.
The waves are propagating towards the shorelines of every continent.
Their speech organs are adequate. The flaw lies not in anatomy, but in the brain.
Objection! Sustain!
Sustain all objections, but face the truth.
What is this supposed to do? Just a mild sedative to help you sleep.
I hate you.
We don't hate you. There's no need for hate now.
Because there's no expectations of what people should or shouldn't be, you are free to create a world where people can be as human as possible, and in some way more purely human than they would be in other type of genres, because there's no expectations.
It can only be attributable to human error